Welcome back, everyone. As most of you know, the iPad 9th generation just came out, so let's go ahead and compare it against the iPad 7th generation and see which one you should pick up. Now, by all means, if you have all the money in the world, then definitely go and pick up the iPad, 9th generation. It's going to be the better iPad in every single area, but the iPad 7th generation is still a pretty decent iPad. It has, it still has a chipset that's supported, and you can get it for much cheaper than the iPad 9. So if that sounds like fun to you, I will leave both of these iPads as well as the 8th gen link down in the description below. You can get them from there and help support the channel at the same time. Now, looking on the front, they actually do have pretty much the exact same design. There really isn't too much of a difference here between them. They have the same exact screen size, the same exact screen panel, the 10.2 inch panels. Now, the main differentiating factor is that the iPad 10.2 inch, the 9th generation of 2021, now has a Retina IPS panel, and the brightness can go up to 500 nits, which is cool, but it also has that True Tone capability, which this is a pretty big differentiating factor. That's something I love seeing on the newer iPads and just newer iPhones in general. True Tone essentially warms the display, so even though the displays look more similar than not, the iPad 9th generation will actually be a better iPad panel overall because of that True Tone technology, which is really awesome in my opinion. Now, both of them have home buttons on the front with Touch ID, which is great. Lightning ports at the bottom, which still look great. Nothing wrong with a lightning port, but USB Type-C is better. And on the back, we have the aluminum backs on both as well. And like I mentioned, I've never felt a cheap iPad. I don't think Apple's ever made a cheap iPad. So both these iPads still feel extremely premium. They don't feel cheap at all. And that is one of the biggest things about this specific iPad. Even with the 7th gen, even with like the 2nd gen iPad, the 1st gen iPad still feels extremely premium. So that's a big thing to keep in mind as well. Now, that pretty much covers it up on the outside. Now, we do have that single camera setup on the back and a single camera setup on the front that we'll go ahead and hit on right now. Now, surprisingly, I don't know why Apple did this. The back cameras are pretty much the same. Apple hasn't really made too many improvements for that back camera. Still an 8 megapixel sensor on both these iPads, 1080p at up to 30 frames, which is okay, I guess. There's nothing really wrong with that. I would have loved to seen even 4K at 30 would have been really nice. Unfortunately, we don't have it here. We have it on those newer iPads like the Mini 6 and the Air 4. We have 4K at 60 on those, but this one is good enough too. I really don't think anybody's going to be picking up an iPad for the camera quality or anything like that, but for the most part, it's still a pretty decent sensor, and if you need a camera, it's equivalent to like an iPhone 6 camera. That's pretty much the best way to put it. I don't want to be too harsh on it, but it is pretty much an iPhone 6 camera when it comes down to it. Now, the front cameras are the more differentiating factor between these. The iPad 7th generation has that 1.2 megapixel 720p camera, where the iPad 9th generation has a 12 megapixel ultra wide camera. So this is a big difference between them. You're getting a much better camera setup on the front than on the back of the iPad. Actually, the front of the iPad 9, in my opinion, is a better camera than the back camera of both of these because it is an ultra wide sensor, and you do have 4K and you do have 1080p at 60 on the iPad 9th generation, which is another really big addition to this thing. So without a doubt, I'm going to tell you this is a big, massive feature of the iPad 9th generation, is having that ultra wide sensor. That's one of my favorite things about it. And like I mentioned, if you need to go pick up an iPad for the camera, that is definitely the one for you. So in terms of the iPad camera setup, that pretty much covers it up there. Now, in terms of longevity, if we're going to get there, I'm definitely going to tell you the iPad 9th generation is definitely going to outlast the iPad 7th generation. Now, the main reason for this is because the iPad 9 has the same chipset as the iPhone 11s, and the iPad 7th generation has the same chipset as the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus. So just kind of putting it in that perspective, that kind of will break down exactly which iPad is going to last how long. I think the iPad 7th generation is probably going to last 2 more years, where quite possibly the iPad 9th generation may last maybe like 3 more years, 4 more years, 5 more years. I mean, it's definitely lasting for a long period of time. We're comparing a 2019 chipset on the iPad 9 to about a 2016 chipset on the iPad 7. So I definitely don't think Apple's going to cut one short. If anything, they're going to extend the life of both of these. So you're definitely going to be getting a longer lasting iPad from the iPad 9th generation without a doubt. So in terms of longevity, that covers it up there. Now let's go and hit on the performance. And like I mentioned, the iPad 7th generation has that Apple A10 Fusion chip inside of it with 3 GB of RAM. And the iPad 9th generation has that Apple A13 Bionic chip inside of it with 3 GB of RAM as well. So you're getting the same amount of RAM on both of these iPads, so it's not like one iPad's going to have better RAM management. Theoretically, the iPad 9 could because it has that newer chipset, but if anything, we're just looking at a speed thing right now, and the iPad 9th generation is definitely going to be faster than the iPad 7. But here's a big thing to keep in mind. With the iPad 7th generation, I have had a pretty good experience with this iPad. It's been a very fast and smooth iPad for the most part. Is it perfect? Absolutely not, but it's a really good performing iPad and I've had very few things wrong with it. I personally think that if I was somebody who was going to use an iPad, the 7th generation would be completely good enough for me. I really don't think it's like, you know, super bad at all or anything like that. And like I mentioned, if you're somebody who needs to pick up an iPad, especially if you're somebody who's something like a student or you're somebody who's kind of along those lines, you're going to be getting a pretty, you know, smooth feeling phone from something like that. So that's a pretty big thing to keep in mind. Now, on the iPad in 9th generation, this is a little bit of a different story. I mean, the iPad 9th generation is going to be the faster iPad between these two. And if you're somebody who's a student and you just want to write documents and those type of things, then the 7th gen, 8th gen, and 9th gen are all going to be good. But on top of that, the iPad 9th generation, if you're wanting to go to do some like intensive gaming and, you know, that kind of stuff, video editing, you're going to be getting a great performing iPad from the iPad 9th generation. So that's another massive, massive thing to tell for sure. So in terms of performance, you're going to be getting a much better performing iPad from the 9th gen than the 7th gen. But for those basic tasks, you know, that we've talked about before, you're going to be getting pretty similar experience on both. But, you know, if you're going up a notch, then definitely the iPad 9 is definitely going to kill it there. So in terms of that, that covers it up there. Now, ending it off with the battery life, what I'll definitely tell you is, from what I've seen, the 7th gen iPad may actually end up having a bigger sized battery than the iPad 9th generation. So we have a 32.9 watt hour battery on the iPad 7. On the iPad 9, we have a 32.4 watt hour battery. So a 0.5 smaller watt hour battery on that iPad compared to the 7th gen, which is very weird. I never really understand why Apple does that. But again, what are we going to do? I'm not really 100% too sure. So when it comes down to it, in terms of a battery standpoint, because of some optimizations and different things like that, you're probably going to be end up getting probably similar battery life. Maybe, you know, because of the similarity of the battery sizes, you may end up getting better battery life from the iPad 9 because of that more optimized chipset. But also, it's very strange Apple hasn't increased the battery size yet, and they actually decreased the battery size with this iPad, which is kind of upsetting for me. So in terms of battery, that pretty much covers it up there. And to be honest, between both of these iPads, I think the iPad 9th generation is by far the better iPad I would recommend. I mean, it has twice the amount of base storage, you know, compared to the iPad 7th gen. It's, you know, the same price tag as the 8th gen from like last month. And it has a lot of capability, and overall, it's a pretty good iPad. You know, I think it's a very tremendous upgrade from the iPad 7. But for basic tasks, you know, if you're somebody who is a student or, you know, you're not expecting too much experience or too much power from your iPad, I think the 7th gen is still going to be fine. I mean, that iPad is barely 2 years old and, you know, it has a lot going for it too. I think I would much rather have a 9th gen iPad than the 7th gen, but the 7th gen is still pretty good in my opinion. So in terms of that, that covers it up there. If you guys have any other questions or anything like that, let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.